Good, how are you?
Thank you, Commissioners. Just to give you a little bit of context and some background information, if you recall at the June 19th meeting, the Library Commission held a public hearing where the item and the proposal to add Linda Brooks-Burton's name to the Bayview Library was first raised. It's a community-led proposal. And as you were presented with materials including approximately 3,000 petition signatures and letters and comments from a broad spectrum of the community. The library naming policy, which you have a copy of, also stipulates that you have a commission meeting either at the location or nearby so you can hear from a broad segment of the community regarding obtaining direct testimony from the public. Just also as a point of information, the policy itself stipulates that any facility has a geographic name, but in rare occasions when the individual merits for support of library goals and mission and service to the community, you can in fact add a name to the geographic name, and that's what we're here to have public comment and testimony with regard to that. And again, I know you'll hear from members of the community. It is wonderful to be here in the Bayview community, but you'll note that Linda Brooks-Burton served the community for many, many years as a branch manager. She was indeed a wonderful librarian, community treasurer, someone that dedicated many years of service to the San Francisco Public Library, and she passed last September. So with that as background, I just thought it would be important to mention that, and I believe that Mr. Walter Johnson is going to be the first person testifying from the community public comment. Thank you.
Good afternoon, Commissioners and City Librarian and Deputy City Librarian. She was a professional librarian, but not only that, her influence extended outside this library. As you can see, it's been remodeled. She was the leader in remodeling this library. Linda opened the door of this library to everyone in the community. Linda Brooks-Burton had one agenda. If it was good for the community, it was okay. Linda spent many a night leaving here late at the expense of her family. Bayview doesn't ask for a lot. We're asking that this library be renamed in her honor. I have a 5-year-old grandson. I want to be able to bring him here and let him know there was a lady named Linda Brooks-Burton that was a dedicated professional community facilitator and that she existed. I want to see her picture and her name out there. Linda gave a lot of herself, not only to the library, but to the Bayview Hunters Point community. She never asked for anything. We, the community, are asking that we give her back an honor and a link. Thank you. Yeah. No one person can tell you everything about Linda outside of the family. You're going to hear different aspects of Linda from the community. As I tell my grandson, open your ears, listen, and you'll get a holistic picture of Linda Brooks-Burton. Thank you.
My name is Marion Chatfield Taylor, and for a long time I worked for Friends of the Library.
So I had the honor of heading up the committee, or I didn't head it up, but I formed the committee that helped to raise the funds, the private side funding for this branch. So, of course, I worked with every library in the city because we went library by library to do that. And they were all great. They all did a great job. They all worked with us well. So I don't want to say, you know, one person was the best, but I think I have to say it. Linda was unbelievable. She was unbelievable. I didn't even have to form a committee. She just gave me a list. She gave me the phone numbers. She called the people. She got the meetings together. You know, when you're trying to organize community by community and you've got several campaigns going at once, you're sort of a three-ring circus. I didn't have to be a three-ring circus in this neighborhood because the community is incredibly responsive. They're incredibly involved and engaged. And she was just a phenomenal, phenomenal resource for us. So, and I feel like everybody said just about everything needs to be said, except I want to thank all the people who did the work for that fundraising and the people who put in the tireless work to make sure that this branch will be named. And I think I'll just echo other people have said, this is non-optional. Thanks.
The founding executive director of the Bayview Hunters Point YMCA. When we started that facility, we did not have that organization. We didn't have a facility. And I could simply pick up the phone and call Linda and say, hey, I need space because I'm doing X, Y, and Z, and it was just okay to do. And we've been colleagues all of these years. So when the Friends of the Library called on me in my most current role and said, we want some support for the new library, it wasn't an issue because Linda got on the phone and said, hey, Cheryl, we need for you to help support through the organization that you're with. My name is outside on the board because not only did I get my organization to support, but I wrote my own check as well because that's what this library means to this community. And so I just urge each of you to listen to what folks are saying. I think everybody has been authentic that has gotten up here. None of us have to get any notes or have anybody tell us what to say because we all know who she's been and what she was to this community. And we just urge you all to vote yes. Thank you.
Everybody here for making this day extraordinarily momentous for me. This is going to be a cherished day for my life. And what you all have brought in your energy and in spirit and what you have given is just, there are not words to fully convey how moved and profound, how deeply moved and how profoundly touched I am. And I'm trembling because this is extraordinary. And so absolutely reaffirming of what we're about, and I promise you, you have my vote and my commitment. So thank you so much for your outpouring of love and reverence to this extraordinary leader, and just bring your incredible insights and thank you.
I just want to comment that one of the greatest things that can happen is when people bear witness to the contributions that an individual has given to a community. And you do that by sharing your narratives, you're sharing your stories. The first public comment was saying, I can only share one piece. But then one person, after the next, and it continued to bring their own personal stories about this extraordinary community member. There are so many things that are happening in San Francisco, that are happening in California, that are happening throughout the world, that we rarely, as people, have an opportunity to hear about the goodness, about the grace, and about the love of someone that has been among us. I am a new commissioner with the San Francisco Public Library. Was sworn in by Mayor Edwin Lee last month. I've lived in San Francisco for about 7 years now. I work at the University of San Francisco. And I know a number of people in this room. I was not afforded an opportunity to be able to give my narrative about my experiences with Linda Burton. Yet, you have honored me as,
anyway, thank you, and I for sure look forward to September, what day is it, 18th, to support this process.
When you open the newspaper and the media, you will hear a negative story. Today is an exception. I do hope that what it is that have been expressed today will show up in media, because we need more stories like this.
Good evening. This is my very first commission meeting, and I have to tell you, it will be a memorable one that I will remember for the rest of my life. It, for one, speaks to the power of libraries and this ability to act as community centers and touch a community and organize a community, but that only happens with people. Otherwise, it's just a building with books. And so the testimony and the truth-telling that we heard today talks about how people can bring it to life, and bring it to life for a community, and not just for the adults, but really for the future of the community with the children. And so I thank you all for taking the time to be in this warm room, and for the food, and for honoring me with this testimony and making my first commission meeting one of the most memorable days of my life as well. Thank you. And you will have my voice.
In the world of politics, you never get total agreement, so it's quite amazing to be in a room today to hear everyone in support of one thing, and that's Linda Brooks-Burton. I feel for her family who lost somebody too young, also to the community, but everyone, her love is in everyone's heart, and we feel it. We appreciate your being able to have us here today and to listen to your stories. Also, all the comments that were also submitted in writing and also by the surveys. So we truly appreciate everything that we've heard, and next month will be an interesting meeting. Thank you. So the next meeting will be at the Main Library Corette Theater. Auditorium. Okay.
They're probably Can I make just one more comment, just so that the community that's here can also know that we have read as commissioners the written letters that were submitted. So if anyone was not in the room but submitted something through the process, we also have that documentation. So we wanted to communicate to you, it's not just the public comment, but also we have all of the letters that have been submitted that we have all read, and want to thank you for doing that.
I know I've spoken, but I just want to say thank you all for coming. And it's been a pleasure hearing you, and especially you, baby. So, I just want to say to you all, thank you, thank you, thank you for coming and being a part of Bayview Hunters Point. Thank you for having me.
We're going to take a short break. 5 minutes?
From video. It's okay. It'll be on YouTube.
Okay.